I'm Cydney Byington. I am an assistant athletic trainer here at Loras College. I usually get in around 8 a.m., have morning treatment hours kind of for anyone who can come in throughout their class schedule in the morning. Any extended rehab stuff we usually try to do then, and then I'm there until about noon. I kind of go home for an extended lunch, do things on my own, and then come back for about an hour before practices start in the afternoon. So it's usually about like 2:33. And then I'm here through whenever practice gets done, usually a little bit after to finish up any rehab stuff after practice. A lot of what people see athletic training as is like your normal like water boy things, making sure athletes stay hydrated throughout the day. So that's one part of what we kind of do. Especially when it's warmer, we monitor for heat illness, signs of that, making sure athletes are getting breaks throughout their practices or competitions. And we also are constantly rehabbing injuries, so that's like part of the stuff behind the scenes that people don't necessarily see all the time. So if an athlete's injured, they can do everything A to B on campus with us, so we're pretty knowledgeable in rehab procedures and stuff like that, pain management, whatever it may be, through the different stages of injury too. Sometimes, especially in runners, we have injuries to the ligaments in the feet, and so what we're gonna do is we're gonna kind of tape through the bottom of the foot to help support those ligaments so they're not getting stressed as much while running and jumping. Get a lot of creative justice with stuff as far as treatment plans and different things, because no two athletes are the same, no two injuries are gonna be the same, and so some people respond better to some forms of treatment versus others, and so just being able to take that and adjust. Sometimes you get some like really weird injuries that there's no like standard tape job for, and so you have to kind of come up with it and how to prevent that motion on your own, and I think that's kind of fun. Athletic training falls under like the healthcare realm, so we want to keep our facilities as clean as possible, prevent spread of illness within our populations that we work with, because athletes are spending a lot of their time together, so if someone gets sick, it tends to go through quite a few people. Some people definitely have a stronger odor than others. Athletes sweat, it kind of comes with the territory. Kind of know that that's what you're getting into when you get into the job. Kind of like a farmer knows that their manure is gonna smell, like it's just kind of comes along with it.